Welcome to the Electronic Devices and Circuits Lab. My name is Omkar Vaidya and I'm from Sandeep Foundation, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Nashik. Simulate LC oscillator using FET is our today's experiment. Before that, what is oscillator? It is an electronic circuit which does not require any input sinusoidal AC signal, though it produces constant frequency of oscillatory signal with constant magnitude. So basically it works on the principle of positive feedback, and once the particular circuit satisfies the Barkhausen criteria, the sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal waveform will get obtained. That is called as oscillator. It has also two types depending on which type of component that we are using in feedback network. Based on that, oscillator has divided into two types, RC oscillator and LC oscillator. Especially in LC oscillator, the feedback path or feedback network consists of inductor and capacitor. Your source signal and feedback signal must be in a phase, that is called as positive feedback. Again, in case of LC oscillator, these oscillators are used to design for high frequency range, whereas RC oscillator are designed for to obtain low frequency sinusoidal waveforms. Now in LC oscillator also there are certain types depending on the component used in feedback network. Generally the three reactances are used, we call it as X1, X2 and X3, in which X1 and X2 are the same type and X3 is of opposite type. If X1 and X2 are the components reactants, especially say X1 and X2 are inductor and X3 is capacitor, then we call it as a Hartley oscillator. And if X1 and X2 is capacitor and X3 is inductor, then we call it as Colpitt oscillator. The object of experiment is to first of all build a such type of circuit and then obtain the frequency of oscillation and verify the frequency of oscillation with theoretical formula the frequency of oscillation and the comparison. Very first we'll see Hartley oscillator, and this is very famous circuit diagram of Hartley oscillator, in which this is amplifier section and this is feedback path. If you see this circuit, this is what called as amplifier section that we already discussed in experiment number 2 as well as in 3, and this path is a feedback path because some part of output is again taken and again it is fed back to input side. And here we are not using any signal generator or function generator to provide any input. So this VCC, generally we also called as VDD, we can also replace it by VDD. As we are talking about JFET, we can also replace it by VDD. So we can go to voltage source, then VDD, can connect here, double click, and we can have 12 volt. So this VDD provides supply voltage, and due to thermionic emission there is a tendency of electronic component through which free electrons move and then will reach here at this drain terminal. This will impose certain voltage, we call it as very less voltage, which is in microvolt, we call it as noise voltage. And this voltage is fed back through feedback network and again given to input. And as it is amplifier, it amplifies this input signal which is fed back from output. And this process is continuously going on, and at certain condition, the gain becomes or the amplitude becomes increased, and at a certain condition the product of magnitude of gain, open loop gain, and feedback factor beta will become 1 or more than 1. So that is nothing but a Barkhausen criteria, and sinusoidal oscillation will start. So this is what oscillator startup mechanism, not only for Hartley but also for Colpitt and Clapp. Now this is feedback section where we are using two inductor and one capacitor, and this is amplifier section. Now we'll try to run, or we'll try to find out the frequency of oscillation. We'll run it. So initially it is a straight line, but then we can have sinusoidal oscillation because we require a certain time to get the product, that is A into beta, is more than or equal to 1. So it will take some time, and then the sinusoidal oscillation will come. So here we can easily observe, and then we have sustained oscillation. Now from this we can able to find out the frequency. So this is very 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 famous experiment where we have unknown frequency, we have waveform, and from that we can able to find out frequency. So we have two cursors, say this is cursor 1, we place it at peak, say here. We have one more cursor and we can place here at this peak, somewhere here or here. Somewhere here. So we can say there are both peaks. We have to check the peaks must be peak. Here is one peak and here is another peak. Or crest must be crest. Here is one crest and here is crest. So that we have to draw one complete cycle. Our basic aim is to find out one complete cycle. And this value, the cycle, is observed here, which is T2 minus T1, which is 142.8857 microsecond. So once we find out, once we are able to find out T, capital T, which is 142.857 microsecond, we just inverse it and we'll get frequency. So for example, time period of oscillation is observed is on oscilloscope is 142.857 microsecond, and if we inverse it, that frequency of oscillation is 1 upon 142.857 microsecond will be 7 kilohertz. So this is a practically frequency of oscillation of Hartley oscillator. Theoretically, we have the formula which is 1 upon 2 pi under root L equivalent into C, where L equivalent is the addition of these two inductors into the capacitance. If you put this value, because we have capacitance 100 nanofarad and inductor, the addition becomes I think 5 millihenry, because 1.1 millihenry plus 3.9 millihenry is 5 millihenry. And theoretically, we will get 7.117 kilohertz. So we can say that the theoretically and practically we can able to compare the frequency of oscillation. So we can say that Hartley oscillator is successfully run. So this is a very easy experiment. Similarly, we can run Colpitt also. We can also run Colpitt oscillator. Now I have directly taken the circuit diagram of Colpitt oscillator. Say this is Colpitt oscillator, the upper part is same, that is amplifier section is same, and just this feedback path part is different, here in which we have two capacitor and one inductor. Two capacitor of having same value, which is 10 nanofarad, and inductor is of 3.9 millihenry. Same is the principle oscillator startup mechanism. Replace this VCC by VDD, because as this is a FET, so we have to use VDD as a voltage source principally, as there is no exceptional changes in the result, though you are using VCC or VDD, but principally we have to use VDD because it is n-channel JFET. Okay, now I will run this experiment. So we have this frequency of oscillation. I will first of all stop it, and then I will try to find out the frequency between them using with the help of cursor. Say this is one peak, and we take one more peak, say here. Say here I have taken one more peak. So peak to peak I have take, you can take at any value, but it should be symmetrical and it must give time period. So this difference, that is T2 minus T1, will be 28.571 microseconds. So time period of this type of oscillator, which is Colpitt oscillator, is 28.571 microsecond, which is observed on oscilloscope. So right, this is 28 point something microsecond. So if you inverse it, you will get 35 kilohertz. Theoretically, we have formula 1/2 pi under root L into C equivalent, where C equivalent is C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2, where C1 and C2 are 10 nanofarad. And if we put the value, we'll get the frequency of oscillation is 36.041 kilohertz. So if we compare this practical value and theoretical value, it came nearby. So result table is like this. So Hartley oscillator, the frequency of oscillation, theoretically value 7.1 kilohertz, practically 7 kilohertz, Colpitt 36.04 and practically 35.63. So this is the working of Colpitt oscillator. Thank you.